Over the past week or so, I've seen a handful of people on Reddit asking how to create a prismatic refractive lighting effect in Blender. This is really useful for adding dynamic color to glass materials. So I gave it a try with pretty promising results. I'll show you how to set it up, and then if you're interested, I'll explain why it works at the end. Let's get started. The first thing you'll want to do is switch from Eevee to Cycles if you haven't already. I'm sure there's a way to make this work in Eevee, but Cycles is usually going to be your best bet if you want to do anything complicated with light. Get rid of the principled BSDF and replace it with a glass BSDF. If you don't need to be walked through this part and you just want to copy my nodes, go ahead and pause here, the nodes are up on the top. Add a white noise texture node, and hook up its value output to the hue input of a hue saturation value node. Set the saturation to 2, the value to 2, and the color to red. Leave the factor as 1. Plug the color output of the hue saturation value node into the color input of the glass BSDF. Add a math node. Set it to multiply, and the second value to 1.8. You don't have to use 1.8 exactly, but this will give you a starting place. Plug the white noise value output into the first value input of the math node. Add another math node, and leave this one set to add. Set the value to 1.3 or so, and connect the first math node's value output to the first value input of the new math node. Then, take that output, and plug it into the IOR of the glass BSDF. Finally, set up the mapping. If you have Node Wrangler enabled, Ctrl-T will do this for you. I use the generated coordinates, but I'm willing to bet some of the other settings will work just fine too. Of course, to see refraction at all, you're going to need ample light, and the default lamp just isn't bright enough. Mess around with it and see what you get. I wound up setting the power to 10,000 watts and the radius to 1 meter. Changing up the geometry, like throwing in some beveling or a modifier, can make the light refract in different ways. Definitely experiment with this and see what you like. This technique uses a principle of light behavior called dispersion. Dispersion occurs because different colors of light refract at different angles when passing through different materials. In Blender, we mimic this effect using the index of refraction, or IOR, in the glass shader. The IOR dictates how light bends when it enters our glass material. There are two main approaches to achieve dispersion in Blender, continuous and discrete. When I was first trying to work this out, I tried discrete dispersion by using 3 separate shaders for red, green, and blue light, and then combining them all at the end with an add shader node. It was interesting, but not what I wanted. What I was going for, and what I showed here, is continuous dispersion. This method uses a white noise texture to generate a random value for each sampling ray, which we then use to adjust both the color and the IOR of our glass shader. By doing this, every color of light hitting our object gets its own IOR, resulting in that smooth, realistic dispersion effect. If you want to play with it even further, consider adjusting the roughness of the glass too. A higher roughness value scatters the light more, softening the dispersion effect. So, that's how you get a nice prismatic refraction effect on glass. That's gonna do it for this video. Thank you everybody so much for watching. If you enjoyed, let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!